This is a tour of the digestive system. The digestive system breaks down food, absorbs nutrients, and excretes waste. The oral cavity, or the mouth, is the initial site of mechanical digestion, where you're going to masticate the food using the teeth. The tongue is mostly skeletal muscle. It's going to help form a bolus of the masticated food. Remember, we have three pairs of salivary glands that are going to produce saliva and help to moisten the food so as it passes through the pharynx. So we have the oral pharynx, the laryngopharynx, passing into the esophagus. The epiglottis is a cartilaginous flap that's going to cover the trachea when you swallow food, so it prevents food and liquid from entering into the lungs, which would be this way. The esophagus has involuntary peristaltic waves of smooth muscle that are going to move that bolus down to the stomach. At the entrance of the stomach, there is a lower esophageal sphincter or cardiac sphincter that prevents the stomach acid from splashing into the esophagus and causing heartburn. The stomach chemically breaks down the bolus using enzymes, and the stomach has three layers of muscles that are going to help with the digestion. The pyloric sphincter regulates the amount of chyme that's released into the duodenum of the small intestines. So the duodenum is about this first 6 inches. The pancreas secretes bicarbonate to neutralize the acidity of the chyme from the stomach. It also secretes enzymes to further digest the chyme. Bile is going to be released from the gallbladder through the common bile duct to the duodenum. The bile breaks down lipids in the small intestines. The gallbladder is on the posterior side of the liver. The liver has multiple functions, one of which is to detoxify your blood before it returns to the heart. Here's the common bile duct. It's going to meet up with the pancreatic duct and dump bile and enzymes into the duodenum. The small intestines has folds that are going to increase the surface area for absorption. On this model, we can see the macroscopic folds called the plicae circularis. So the next section of the small intestines is the jejunum, followed by the ileum. The ileocecal valve, it's a sphincter that's going to regulate the amount of fecal matter coming from the ileum into the cecum. The cecum is a blind pouch of the large intestines. It has the appendix that is inferior to it. The large intestines has several regions, including the ascending colon, which goes up, the transverse colon, which goes across, and the descending colon that comes down. And then the sigmoid colon is going to connect the descending colon to the rectum. The rectum is going to end at the anus. We have an internal anal sphincter that is involuntary, and we have an external anal sphincter that is voluntary, and these are going to help with the defecation reflex. Another thing to note on the intestines, we have this tiny coli. It is a band of smooth muscle that is going to cause the pouches called hostra to form.